Hello, this is Echoing Clock.
And Ripper 95, a.k.a. Cool Guy 902. And we're alone for this part of the recording session.
So, we're just exploring Misty Island to find the last of the collectibles that we don't have. And after we finish this, we'd like to go ahead and talk to Kira about her egg craft zoomer and how it's going to get us past
the bottom. Now it's egg craft, right? Egg.
I believe so. I might be wrong.
I always thought that kind of weird. Egg craft? Is it like run off eggs? No, but it runs off power cells though.
Oh. No, the heat shield runs off power cells.
What does it actually run off of?
I don't know.
Because from the looks of it, they don't have gas in here. All they have is blue eco, which you would have to apparently have a constant stream of. Which you obviously don't, because we've seen the zoomer right there.
Well, it looks like it might be having blue eco pumped into it from there. Maybe yeah. That's just a teleport. Another blue portal.
Oh my god.
So, exploring this place, it's a really big map. It gets tedious. What I'm looking for is around here somewhere. Where is it? Who knows? I'm sure I'll know eventually.
Oh wait, turn around. Nope, back towards the island. Main island. There you go. Now, if from here you get a really good view at everything.
So like, there's the, there's Reinstage's house, there's Forbidden Temple, there's Dirigibold.
Dirigibold.
That's why?
You said Dirigibold.
Oh, okay.
There's no bold, it's Dirigible.
Dirigibold.
Strike you every time you pronounce it wrong from every. Let it be known that if you hear a loud smack, it's because Echoing Clock has mispronounced something.
Oh goodness.
And let me know that it's his fault.
Okay then.
And only he has the power to stop it.
The Ridgeable.
There you go.
Strike me no more!
Nah, maybe later I'll hit you just because I feel like it.
Okay.
There's nothing down here. There never was.
Yeah, there never was. Probably
Why
never.
Are you going?
And I'm back. From the beginning.
You are so bad at this. It's obviously where the rest of them are.
Where?
Do I have to take control from you again?
Yeah.
Oh.
You took too long. Alright, so now Ripper 95 is playing. He claims that he may or may not know where the lost of them are. And he knows where they are. And that's that.
There we go. Why are you the one playing this if I'm the superior person?
Because you're an egotistical bastard.
Hey, I'm not that bad. I could invite Drew again.
I'd rather you didn't. It brings me back to the beginning.
In other words, you just suck.
No, one of the better-
That, you suck.
Okay. So, let's jump back in the fisherman's boat. Just drive bottom back over to home. Send over village. Show me the way to go home. I'm tired and I wanna go to bed. Yes, that was a Jaws reference.
Or just a fisherman reference.
Well, so
take your pick. Now let's go talk to the guy who I'm pretty sure is the only drug reference in this game. I'm pretty sure that's a stereotype, but I really don't care, because I've met stoners and I talk just like this guy.
Oh, the muse! You saved her! Oh, you really are the best.
That's here, like your opinion,
man. Take this parcel. I won't need it now that I have my inspiration back.
Parcel? I thought a parcel was like an umbrella.
Oh, we still need to buy two more power cells, don't we?
So let's come over here, and this is my adopted uncle's house.
Apparently. I've never met this chap before in my life.
Well, Hello there, my dear boy.
He's apparently British, where everybody else on the island is tropical.
I was set off on my journey yesterday, but I seem to be a spot short on the old precursor orbs. I would have pledged my word that I had 90 of them, but I gather that your young friend, you know, the little annoying, miserably ugly one, might have just pilfered them as a sort of a spot of fun. Anyway, would you be kind enough to loan your dear old uncle 90 precursor orbs so he can get underway? I would offer you a power cell in return.
Sure, why not? You seem like an okay guy.
Yeah. And what's the other one? I have 90 and the other Oracle one.
I see you two are back to make the trade.
You might hear like slight little pops of whirs in the background. That's because we're right next to a highly volatile electrical area. So if you hear us suddenly screaming in pain, that's because one of the wires is electrocuted us.
These videos wouldn't be uploaded if we were electrocuted.
I'm sure somebody would upload them. My dying breath will be to tell someone in our class to upload them for us.
Upload these videos!
Probably not that stupid sounding, but whatever.
Regardless.
Bleh.
Yeah, you don't really die until you say bleh. Hasn't Red vs. Blue taught us anything?
And that was us referencing Red vs. Blue by Rooster Teeth. Probably.
If you're watching a Let's Play, I'm pretty sure you know what Red vs. Blue is.
Yeah. It's a great machinima. If you haven't seen it,
there's something wrong with you.
Look it up.
You have proven yourself worthy. Here is a power cell.
And that's the second power cell.
So basically, if I acquire enough money, I can get a free energy.
That's right.
That's what they're teaching me. How my PlayStation hasn't caught fire yet is beyond me, because I've been leaving it on for several hours straight while we're recording this. And yes, we are using my PlayStation, because Echoing Clock's PlayStation, the right audio is shot. I really don't want to talk to her. Can we just skip this?
Nah, probably not.
Great! You have the 20 cells needed to power up. My heat shield. Now be careful. The shield will only protect your zoomer till it reaches 500 degrees, so try to keep her cool. Flying over open lava will definitely heat you up fast.
What's with the wristbands?
500 degrees,
they're like,
and it's over.
Code.
Over? Like burning molten metal?
Protect
over?
Me, code.
The fire cannon gets pretty hot.
Shut up the references.
So keep a lookout for jumps to keep you off the hot ground. I've also released several blue cooling balloons you can use to drop the shield's temperature quickly. Oh, and when you get across, don't forget to activate the teleport gate in the Blue Sage's lab. Then we'll be able to teleport over and meet you. Good luck!
Now, what I've always noticed is that it always, to me, looks like there's yellow eco coming out of the lava, which kind of goes into what the Green Sage was talking about a lot in the beginning of the game, about how, like, you get eco from nature, and how, like, from the sounds of it, they established really well, actually, that, like, you get blue eco from lightning and electricity, you get green eco from plant life, you get yellow eco from magma and stuff. Oh my god, if you die.
And that's the death animation.
Wow. I can't believe
to
you died on that.
To be completely honest, no one's gonna get it on their first try anyway. And if you are, props to it.
I got it on my first try.
On your fifth playthrough?
Oh, yeah, well, on my fifth playthrough, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, also, if you're going for 100%, you're probably going to die. If you're not going for 100%, then you're gonna make this first try.
Yeah. Because odds are you're gonna go out of your way.
And also, Echoing Clock is forgetting that he has a jump ability, which will help him a lot with these open ways over open magma pits like that.
Rico does speed you up.
Doesn't cool you down, but it does speed you up. Oh, and that's gonna cost you, Russ.
gonna call you Rust from now on, like from National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation. Or any of the National Lampoon movies. Oh, get it? Okay, we're one away from a power cell. Oh, grab it.
That was exemplary badass.
Badass? Let's just say badass is a word. Just ignore you for the rest of the video.
Alright, so with this, we're gonna call that episode. We're gonna start the next episode with activating the Blue Sage portal. So this has been Echoing Clock.
Rip for 95, a.k.a. Cool Guy 902.
Bye.
See yous.